Hello, baseball fans. Anthony with BBSN, and we are back for start number 19 of our 1969 Fergie Jenkins payoff pitch replay. And in tonight's game, the Pittsburgh Pirates, who have been a frequent foe of the Cubs as of late with Fergie on the mound, visit Wrigley Field, and Bob Veal, part of the exotic game pitching staff, which also includes Bob Moose, but is missing Ed Lamb, takes on Fergie in what will be a replay of a 625-69 game won by the Cubbies 5-2. And you can see at this point in the replay, Fergie, a game in which he was injured his last time out, coming off his first no decision of the replay. In real life at this point in time, he was 8-5 with a 2.83 ERA, 140 innings pitched. And in the replay, he is 14-3, a stellar 1.78 ERA and 141.2 innings pitched, despite leaving early in his last start. He had 119 Ks in real life at this time, 125 in the replay, and 10 more walks, 28-18, and had also given up 4 more home runs in real life than he has in the replay, 12-8. And today's starting lineup for the Pirates, a familiar lineup for the time period. Matty Alou leads off in center. Richie Hebner bats second at third. Roberto Clemente in right. Pop Stargell at first. Jose Pagan gets the start in left field tonight over Al Oliver. Jose Martinez in for Bill Mazeroski at second. Jerry May behind the dish, Freddie Patek at short, and the aforementioned Bob Veal on the hill. And for the Cubbies, no changes with the exception of the second spot, where Nate Oliver is in for Paul Popovich, who has started the last couple of Fergie appearances. Apart from that, same old crew, Kessinger, Williams batting third, Ron Santo fourth, Mr. Cubby fifth, Randy Hundley behind the plate, Jim Hickman in right, and Don Young in center field. And tonight in our game, as an added attraction, we will have a third inning character. Actually, a feature I'm going to start doing. We'll have our fun facts in the seventh inning, and we will have a feature baseball character after the third. And today is Arthur Bugs Raymond, who was a pitcher for the Giants in the dead ball era from 1909 to 1911. And a short career, but an unforgettable one. And you'll hear a few things about Bugs when we get past the third. So that said, everyone is ready to go. Let's play ball. Fergie facing Matty Alou for the Pirates. Top of the first. And right away, we have a ballpark check, and against the right-handed pitcher, that's going to be an in-play result for Matty Alou. And Alou, and that will be a fly ball to left field, and Williams over to put that away, one down. Next up, the youthful 22-year-old Richie Hebner, the pitch from Fergie. Tough, and Fergie comes high and tight. Hebner gets a hold of it and drives it into shallow right field. And there to put that away is Jim Hickman, two down. And Fergie, not missing a beat, bouncing back from his injury. And ballpark for Roberto Clemente, also going to be an in-play result. And Clemente, 95, and that is going to be a medium fly ball to left. So Billy Williams, his second put out of the inning. And as he is prone to do, Fergie comes through with the three up, three down inning. And we head to the bottom of the first. Bob Veal on the mound and facing Kessinger, and that's going to be a in-play result. And Kessinger, he's going to fly out to right field. So one down as Roberto Clemente comes in, makes the basket catch, brings up Nate Oliver, the second baseman. And tough result, and Oliver drives that into left field. So the ball is in the air, could lead to some home runs later, but this one leads to a put out by Jose Pagan. So two down for the Cubbies. Sweet swinging Billy Williams up ballpark, and 32. That is going to be a wheelhouse result. Billy Williams, a big cut against the southpaw. And that ball is gone, no doubt about it. Sweet swinging Billy Williams. Deep into the Chicago afternoon, because they didn't play night games then. A solo home run with two outs gets the Cubbies on the board, and Fergie, a 1-0 lead is often all he needs, and Billy Williams gives it to him. Ron Santo up next. And that's going to be in play, and Santo, dice is cocked there. Santo is going to drive that in the gap. That's going to be a stand-up double. So Veal shaken up by that clout by sweet swinging Billy Williams. Runner on second base, Ernie Banks up, Mr. Cubby. Looking to provide a little bit more space, and four is going to be patient. And Ernie Banks going to ground that down to shortstop, and up with that is Freddie Patek. Whips it over to Pops, and the Pirates are out of the inning, but not before the Cubbies strike for a run on two hits, one left. As Billy Williams gives the Cubbies 1-0 lead, we head to the top of the second inning. Pop Stargell up, and Fergie, high heat down the plate. Stargell swinging a miss, strike three, sit him down. Willie back to the dugout. Jose Pagan up. And Fergie, that's going to be in play. And Pagan, he just cues that off the end of the bat, pokes it into right field, and he's on with a one-out single. And Pagan, he is a decent base stealer, and he's going to give it a shot, but he needs a three to be able to run, doesn't get it. So Jose Martinez up, one down, runner on first. And Fergie, we're going to have a defensive check, go to the fast action cards. Be a range check on the left fielder, sweet swinging Billy Williams, who is a D, and a roll of 50. Not very good for sweet swinging Billy Williams, and that is going to fall in. And it will be a single. Runner advances two bases, so first and third now. So Fergie, after a strikeout of Pop Stargell to start the inning, gives up back-to-back singles. Pirates at the corners, and the catcher, Jerry May, steps up to the dish, digs in. Fergie kicks, delivers, nine, tough, swing and a miss, strike three. May goes down. And he flailed helplessly at that slider from Fergie. Two down, Freddie Patek up. Runners at the corners. Nine, and that's going to be tough. And Patek gets a hold of that, but a fly ball into left field, no problem for Williams. And the Pirates get a couple of base runners, but Fergie rises to the occasion, shuts them down. We head to the bottom of the second inning, 1-0 Cubbies up. As Bob Veal faces Randy Hundley, and Veal, that'll be a tough, and 73, it's going to be a fly ball to center field, and coming in to take that is Matty Alou, one down. Hundley heads back to the dugout, right fielder Jim Hickman up, and Hickman versus left-handers hit 302 in 1969, patient result, and he's going to drive that into left field. Pagan over to take that, and two down. So Veal, of the five outs recorded thus far, four of them have been in the air, plus the home run and double. So he is keeping the ball up. We'll see if that continues to be an issue. And nine is tough. Not with Don Young, though. Swing and a miss, blows him away. Three up, three down for the Cubbies in the second. So Veal bounces back, and we head to the top of the third, still 1-0 for the Cubs. And Veal himself steps in. Fergie looking to put him away, and five is going to be patient, and 13. And Veal, his counterpart, draws a base on balls. So not the way Fergie wanted to start that inning with the opposing team's pitcher up. Back to the top of the order, Matty Alou. And Veal puts on the jacket. Alou digs in. Here comes a pitch. And 10, that'll be in play. And a fly ball to right field. Veal goes back to first base. One down. It's a nice routine drive there for Hickman to put away. Richie Hebner up. And the young third baseman, he's going to get a tough play. And 40. Hebner is going to drive that up the middle and single. And that's blooped in there, and runner on first advances one base. So runners on first and second, third hit Fergie's given up. So a little hit and miss for Jenkins early, already given up three hits and a walk to go with a couple of strikeouts. And Roberto Clemente up, runners on first and second, one away. Fergie needs a big pitch, ballpark, wheelhouse. And Clemente going to take a big hack at this, and it is deep going, and it is gone over the left field wall. Roberto Clemente, a three-run blast, and Fergie is touched up. And he has avoided the home run in big situations, but not today. A three-run shot gives the Pirates a 3-1 lead. As Clemente trots around the bases and the ball comes back out of the stands, they didn't even like to keep him back in 69. Bases are cleared, one out for Pop Stargell. And tough result, Fergie back with a vengeance, swing and a miss, Stargell goes down. So strikeout number three for Fergie. Unfortunately, the long ball not doing him any favors as Jose Pagan steps in. Pagan set, here comes the pitch in play, and that's going to be a ground ball down to first base. Ernie Banks backhands that, trots to the bag, and the inning is over. But the Pirates strike big, two hits, three runs. And of course, the big blast, the three-run rocket by Roberto Clemente. And we head to the bottom of the third. Pirates up 3-1 over the Cubbies. And an unfamiliar situation in this replay for Fergie, as he will lead off the inning. And seven's going to be tough. And Fergie swinging a miss. Veal fires three past him. Fergie back to the dugout. And that's Veal's second strike out of the ball game. Back to the top of the order, and Don Kessinger will be the batter. Kessinger, here comes a pitch, and that's going to be tough. 63, and Kessinger fights that off, but it's going to be a harmless ground ball down to second base. And up with that is Jose Martinez, whips it over to Stargell, two down. So Veal, after a rough first inning, has settled in nicely. Nine, that'll be tough to Nate Oliver, and that's going to be a fly ball to left field. And can of corn for Pecan out there, so seven in a row set down now for Veal. Cubs down 1-2-3 again, and we're heading to the top of the fourth inning. Pirates 3, Cubbies 1. And let's get to our fun fact of the game, Bugs Raymond. So Raymond, As was kind of a tradition in the dead ball era, an era full of characters, Raymond, he joined the Giants in 1909 and was a notorious boozer, which forced John McGraw to keep a close eye on him. In fact, McGraw would send Raymond's paychecks to Raymond's wife, who was actually an invalid, but couldn't really take care of herself, and Bugs didn't take care of her, but she was the one that got his money, and only because it kept him out of the bars where he would have probably blown through all of his paychecks. Unfortunately, Bugs needed the bottle more than he really needed baseball, and in 1911, kind of the low point of his time with the Giants, he was actually caught during spring training in the kitchen of the hotel the Giants were staying at, licking up remains of martinis out of empty glasses off the tray. And pretty much that was the beginning of the end for him. He was sent to the bullpen in the fifth inning to get ready for a game one day, and by the seventh, he had left and gone to a saloon, and Giants released him. That was basically the end of his big league career, unfortunately, and unfortunately also pretty much the beginning of the end for him life-wise. And you know, Raymond was actually a very good pitcher. He had a 2.48 ERA during his time in the bigs, or 2.49 ERA. And so there was some ability there. He just could not keep sober. And unfortunately, in 1912, during a drunken brawl in a saloon, Raymond was kicked in the head, and he died shortly thereafter of a fractured skull, aged 30 years old. So That is the brief story of the unfortunate demise and shortened career of Bugs Raymond, one of the characters of the early part of the game during the dead ball era of the 19th or 20th century. So back to the ball game, and Jose Martinez leading off the fourth for the Pittsburgh visitors. And that's going to be a tough result, and Martinez gets a hold of that, drives it into left field, no problem for Williams, though, one down. Jerry Mayup and the Pirates catcher, he struck out his first time, and Fergie, it's going to be a patient result, and May drives that into left field as well, and another easy put out for Billy Williams out there. And Freddie Potek. Potek flew out to Williams in the second inning. And six will be a tough result. And 43, Potek ticks it, but Hundley holds on. And strike three, that's number four for Fergie. And the Pirates down 1-2-3 in the fourth. So Fergie looking to regain composure as we head to the bottom of the inning. And Pittsburgh leads this one 3-1. Billy Williams leads it off for the Cubbies. And four, it's going to be patient. And Williams, ground ball down to third base. Hebner up with it over to Stargell. 5-3 on the putout. One away here in the fourth. There's Ron Santo, the Cubbies' cleanup hitter. And third baseman himself steps in. Patient to Santo. And he's going to work a base on balls. Trots down to first base as the southpaw misses on a 3-1 count. So the Cubbies have their first base runner since the first inning, and Santel, not a threat to run. He's going to hope for Ernie to make some magic. And that'll be an in-play result, and Ernie Banks, ground ball down to shortstop, and 10. That's going to be outside both Fields and Banks' double play rating, so the only play is going to be over to first base. 6-3 on the putout, and down to second goes Ron Santel. Two down for Randy Hundley. And Hundley looking to get the Cubbies closer. Not going to happen there, though. Tough, and that's going to be a fly ball to left field. Jose Pagan ranges to his left and gloves that, and the inning's over. So no hits, no runs, no errors. One left, and we're heading to the fifth inning, still 3-1 Pittsburgh. As Bob Veal, who's kept the Cubbies in check, steps in to start the inning, and that's going to be an in-play result. And that will be a fly out to right field. So easy put out for Hickman out there, one down. And back to the top of the order for Matty Alou. Alou has flown out twice to left and right. And here comes a pitch, and that's going to be tough from Fergie. And Alou grounds that down to shortstop, and Kessinger up with it, whips that over to first base, two down. Richie Hebner, the batter, left-hander, digs in against Fergie. And 10's going to be in play, and Hebner grounds that down to second base, and up with that is Nate Oliver. His first start at second during the replay as Fergie has another 1-2-3 inning. We head to the bottom of the fifth, 3-1, Pirates still lead it. And Jim Hickman, going to try and get a little rally going for these Southsiders. 8 is going to be tough, and Hickman, ground ball down to shortstop, and Potek, the easy put out there, one down. As center fielder Don Young steps in. And 11, patient Young lifts a high fly ball into left field, and coming in to get that is Pagan. And Pagan is a busy man out and left for the Pirates. That is two outs, and Pagan has a total of 5 putouts thus far in this game as Fergie steps in. Too early to worry about taking him out. That's going to be tough, and Fergie's going to have another tough out into the plate. Has 4 pitches, 3 strikes, and he's back to the dugout. So Veal doing his 3 up, 3 down thing again, and we're heading to the 6th inning. Pirates still lead this one by 2, 3-1. Roberto Clemente steps in against Fergie, and Fergie, patient. And Clemente, he's going to drive that right back up the middle, base hit. So Roberto, 2-for-3, and of course the big blow, that 3-run blast back in the third. And Clemente is going to try and steal. He needs a 3 or better, not going to get the jump. So Pop Stargell will leave it up to him, and that's going to be another defense check, and that was trouble the first time. This will be an error check on the second baseman. And down there we have Nate Oliver, who is a four. And fortunately, he is a adequate fielder. Just gets to that, makes a nice play. And 11, not going to be able to get the runner at second base, but whips it over to first base to retire Stargell. So 4-3 on the put out, and Clemente down to second, one down. Jose Pagan up, and Fergie. 3, tough, 41, Pagan, and he is down on strikes again, Fergie. It's going to be his fifth strikeout of the game, so 2 down. And next up will be Jose Martinez, and Jose, 1-for-2, single back in the second. And 9, that'll be a tough result, and Martinez, a fly ball out to shallow left field, sweet swinging Billy Williams in. Takes it in stride, trots back to the dugout, so the Pirates get a hit. But no runs, no errors, leave one. We're heading to the bottom of the sixth inning. Still 3-1 Pittsburgh, and Kessinger set to try and change the tide for the Cubbies, and 6 will be in play result, and Kessinger flies out to right field. So one quick out, 2 pitches into that at bat, brings up Nate Oliver. And Oliver today has flown out to left field twice, and that's going to be patient result. And he's going to make that the trifecta, another fly ball out to Pagan, who continues to be busy. So 2 outs on the F7, sweet swinging Billy Williams up. And Williams, he went deep himself back in the first, a solo shot. In play result, Williams hit on the ground to third base. Hebner gloves it, whips it to Stargell, and another 3 up, 3 down inning for Veal. And Veal, he was 13-14 with a 3.23 ERA in 1969, and he's having a fine outing today against the Cubs. As we head to the seventh inning, Fergie Jenkins facing Jerry May, and 7's going to be an in-play result, and May pops that up, and circling under that is Nate Oliver, puts it away, one down. So F4 on the put out, and that brings up Freddie Patek. Went on to be an integral part of the Kansas City Royals in the early to mid-70s. And 4, going to be a ballpark check, and that's Wheelhouse and Freddie Patek. Not a big stick, but can he get Fergie? And he cannot. Instead, grounds that down to Banks, hit hard, but Banks up with it, walks to the bag himself, 2 down. And Bob Veal up for his third time today, and Veal has walked and flown out to right field, and 11 is going to be another defensive check, and it's going to be an error check on the second baseman, Nate Oliver, who is a 4, and 11, unfortunately, is going to be an error, and that will be a 1 base error, so Oliver boots the ground ball. Bob Veal has been on twice. And this one, the result of the E4. So back to the top of the order, and Fergie needed to get out of that without having to start back at the top of the Pirates order, which is quite potent. As Matty Alou, one of the ballpark or ball playing Alou brothers, steps in, and that is a ballpark result. 68 is going to be in play, Alou. 36 or less needed, does not get it. It's going to be a fly out to left field. Sweet swinging Billy Williams takes care of that. And the Pirates, no hits, no runs, no errors, one left, one error, I should say. And we're heading to the bottom of the seventh inning. Pittsburgh still up 3-1 on the strength of Roberto Clemente's 3-run shot in the third. And our fun facts, our seventh inning stretch fun facts. Some numbers to play with here. In 1947, the Liebman Brewery offered $100,000 to broadcast the 1947 World Series, and the baseball commissioner, Happy Chandler, he actually passed on the offer because he thought it was inappropriate to have a sponsor of an alcoholic beverage sponsor the World Series, basically. And That would have been about, oh, just about a little over $1 million in today's dollar, which is still a bargain for broadcasting the World Series. And they actually ended up taking less than that. The final bid of $65,000, which was offered by Gillette and Ford in a combined effort. And they televised the World Series, which came out to about $700,000 in today's dollar. So definite bargain to broadcast the Fall Classic. And the unfortunate part for most of America is that it was shown only in New York City. So there you go, our seventh inning fun facts as we head to the bottom half. And Ron Santo trying to get something going here for the Cubbies, and that'll be a tough result. Ground ball down to shortstop. Patek up with it, whips it to Stargell. And one down to start the seventh inning for the Cubs. That brings up Mr. Cubby Ernie Banks. And Ernie today is grounded out to shortstop twice, and eight will be tough. 32, and he's not going to do it this time. Swing and a miss. Strike three is Veal. Has him out in front on the change of pace. Brings up Randy Hundley with two outs. Hundley looking to get something going. And that'll be a defensive check for Veal. And range check on the shortstop. And out at short for the Cubbies is Patek, who has a range of C. 22, not going to get to that as Stargell or Hundley gets a single to get the Cubbies a little bit of life here with two outs in the seventh. And that is only their second hit of the, or third hit of the ball game. So Veal doing work here, two outs, Jim Hickman. Here comes a pitch and 10's going to be in play. Hickman, it'll be a ground ball down to third base and Hebner goes a short way to second. And Cubbies retired, one hit. No runs, no errors, one left, and we're heading to the eighth. Veal in control, Pirates lead at 3-1. So we'll probably see the last of Fergie this inning, and he is still good, actually. Yeah, Fergie's good until the ninth. So he is still gonna be fresh as Richie Hebner steps in. And seven in play, Hebner, he's going to drive that sharply into center field. And Richie's second base hit of the day. And of course, on his first, he ended up scoring on the home run by this man, Clemente. So six, tough, not this time. Fergie comes in with a hard slider, buckles the knees, and Clemente watches that go by. Called strike three, bowl a special K for him. Back to the dugout, Willie Stargell up. Nine, another tough result. Fergie on fire now, blows that right by high and hard. Stargell can't catch up with it. Two down, another strikeout for Jenkins. So Fergie looking to finish here with a strong eighth inning. Stepping in and patient to Jose Pagan. And Pagan, he's going to single, and that is going to get line drive into center field. Runner on first advances two. He would have anyway because there's two outs. And there's going to be action in the Cubbies' bullpen. They will need to replace him anyhow. And down there is the left-hander, Rich Nye, beginning to warm up for the Cubs. So he's going to come in for Fergie in the ninth inning, if not sooner. Hopefully ninth inning. So as he warms up, Jose Martinez, Pirates second baseman for the day, steps in, and Fergie, that's going to be an in-play result, and Martinez fly out to right field, coming in to take that is Hickman. So first and third, the Pirates get a couple of hits, but strand two, and Fergie keeps it tight as we head to the bottom of the eighth inning. And Fergie will be up second in this inning after Don Young. So Young looking to get something going against Veal, and tough, not going to happen here. A fly ball to center field. And going into the gap a few steps, Matty Lou brings that in. We're going to have a pinch hitter for Fergie now. And coming off the Cubbies bench, the usual second baseman, Glenn Beckert, and he actually hasn't started a few games. So Becker steps in and Veal one away. Here comes a pitch. And nine, tough. And Becker grounds that down to second base. And ranging to his left is Martinez. Flips it over to first, two down. So Becker does not get it done. Back to the top of the order. And Don Kessinger steps in. Kessinger today has been 0-for-3. Ground out, two flyouts, and tough result. And Veal, the left-hander. Kessinger fights off a tough pitch on the outside corner, loops that into center field, and the Cubbies have their fourth hit of the day. Two-out single by Kessinger. And that brings up second baseman Nate Oliver. Oliver, who has flown out to left field in all three of his previous at-bats. We go for the sombrero, and tough result, and Oliver against the left-hander. Not going to get a piece of that, as swing and a miss, strike three. So Veal continues to come up big when he has to, and eight innings are in the books, folks, and it's 3-1 Pirates. And Cubbies will have the meat of their order in the ninth inning. And it's up to Rich Nye to keep the Pirates at bay as he faces Jerry May leading off the inning for the Pirates, top of the ninth. Here we go. And six, tough. Jerry May, swing and a miss, strike three. So Rich Nye comes inside, busts him on the knuckles. And May goes down swinging. Freddie Patek, the batter. And pitch to Patek, that's going to be in play, and a ground ball down to Kessinger. Kessinger whips it over to Banks, two down. And they're going to let Veal go the distance here with a 3-1 lead. He's got a four-hitter going, why not? And eight, going to be a ballpark result, and that's going to be in play. Veal needs a nine or better, not going to happen there. Ground ball down to Kessinger again. So Candy Hop whips it over to Mr. Cubby, and three up, three down for the Pirates, and we're heading to the bottom of the ninth inning. Pittsburgh holding on to a 3-1 lead, and Bob Veal looking to get the complete game. He's got to go through the meat of the order to do it, starting with sweet swinging Billy Williams. And five, patient, 21, and Williams draws a base on ball, second walk that Veal has given up. So the Cubbies have life, and speaking of life, they're going to get some life out in the bullpen. And up and warming up furiously is Joe Gibson, 5-1, a 1.93 ERA in 1969 as Ron Santos steps up to the plate. Williams gets his lead. Here comes a pitch from Veal. Patient, 44. Santo draws another base on ball, so Veal losing it a little bit here, and he's got to face at least one more batter in order to be eligible to be relieved. So Ernie Banks going to try and make him pay. Three defensive checks, 63. This could go either way, folks. And that's going to be an error check on Mr. Veal himself. And the pitcher, he is a four. Unfortunately, a good fielding pitcher. So 63, going to be an out. And double play result underneath both Banks and Veal's double play rating. So Bob Veal makes a nice stab. Whips it back to Patek, who goes over to Stargell. Over to third goes Billy Williams, but the 1-6-3 double play. And that has Mr. Veal and the Pirates one out away from defeating the Cubbies and Fergie 3-1. Randy Hungley, the next last chance. Here comes a pitch from Veal, still fresh. Six, going to be in play, 23. And Randy Hungley drives a single into left field, and that's going to get the second run home for the Cubbies. So a big RBI single for Randy Hundley. That brings up Jim Hickman and a mound visit coming up. Veal, he fatigues in the eighth, but he is still only giving up two runs. He has to be more than two to be fatigued. So, after the conversation, Veal keeps the ball. They're going to let him try and do this himself. Jim Hickman up. Here comes a pitch. Six in play, and Hickman, that's going to be a fly ball to left field, and going back for that is Pagan, and runs it down right before the warning track. Third out, ball game over. So the Cubbies get a couple of walks, a hit, and play to run in the bottom of the ninth, but it's not going to be enough as Fergie and the Cubs fall to Pittsburgh 3-2 in start number 19 of this 1969 payoff pitch replay. So Bob Veal, an exceptional performance, five hits, gave up two runs, both earned, one of them a shot into the seats by Billy Williams. And he strikes out one, two, three, four, five, and walks three. Fergie, the tough luck loser, and that's going to drop Fergie to 14-4 on this replay. And Fergie still manages to go eight innings. And he gives up four, five, seven hits. So eight innings, seven hits, three runs, all three of them earned, all coming on the long ball by Roberto Clemente. And Fergie is going to get charged with only one free pass. And strikes out eight. So really not a bad outing for Jenkins. Unfortunately, he gives up the big home run ball to Clemente. And that was the difference in this one. So final line score, Pirates, three runs on seven hits, no errors. Cubbies, two runs on five hits, one error. And that is the ball game. So we'll be back with start number 20 at a later time. And just a quick update on the channel. We now sit at 201 subscribers in our seventh month of operation. So thank you to everyone who has been supporting the channel. And as I mentioned earlier, I think in the Triumphs and Tragedy of the Ring, the Luther McCarty, Arthur Pelkey vlog, few days back, we are going to have another giveaway based on hitting 200 subscribers, and it is going to involve Glory Days Boxing. So a very early, I guess, small beta package will be available to someone, and I'm going to do a video tomorrow with some more details on that. So as always, thank you everyone who has subscribed. Appreciate the support. Appreciate you watching. Please thumbs up the video. Leave any comments, suggestions, thoughts you'd like to. And until next time, oh, and I would be remiss too, just subscribe to Retro Sports. Oh, darn it. Ron Juckett's channel, Retro Sports Network. He's building up his subscriber base, so go give him a look. He's got a variety of, actually every season of PC, Action PC Baseball from 1900 on, a lot of the football seasons as well. So he's looking to do a Tuesday and Thursday live broadcast. So please give him a look and subscription and support. Ron does a great job. Really, really awesome with the chats with Alan friends that you'll see him drop in from time to time. Just an all-around great guy, and always support the other friends of the channel. Al Red Sox fan, busiest man on YouTube, ID Gesture, currently doing some Pillars of Eternity 2, which is actually a game that I play here and there. Very fun computer game. Chris at Strat-o-matic Delaware doing some digging deep boxing, and I know it's technically a competition with a game I'm developing, but it is a great game. Check it out, Digging Deep Sports. Some very very fun and quick play sports games. So Chris currently has those going on his channel. Higher Ground Gaming, Eric there. Tabletop Sports, The Earl and Earl Show. Ken Castro, Clinton Parks. And What's Blazing in Sports does a lot of boxing talk. Very entertaining channel, fun to watch. Broke Black Man 94, TV reactions, and all the rest. I know I'm missing a couple. I apologize. Oh, David, Baseball Demos, definitely give him a look as well. They're all in the left-hand side of my main page. So support the friends of the channel and everyone in the genre. And again, thank you for watching. Have a good night. And until next time, keep swinging for the fences. We'll see ya.